I'm sure by now you know that conflict is perfectly normal in marriage, but how much is too much conflict, and how do you know if your marriage is healthy and successful? Well, in this video, I'm going to talk to you about something called the magic ratio and how you can use that to tell if your marriage is successful and healthy. Hi, my name is Michelle Perda, and I'm a life and marriage coach for moms, and I help moms create the marriage that they can love and enjoy and have their kids look up to. So, what the heck is the magic ratio? The magic ratio is a concept that the Gottman Institute created, and I'm going to share with you how this can help you figure out if your marriage is on the right track and if there's work to be done. So, the Gottman Institute actually says that for couples, you need to have five positive interactions for every one negative interaction. And for successful couples, that ratio actually needs to be higher, more like 20 to 1. So 20 positive interactions for every one negative interaction, like an argument, like a fight. If the ratio of your marriage is lower than 5 to 1, that's actually a warning sign that your marriage is in danger of potential separation, divorce, or misery for life. Here are nine things to look out for. Number one, being critical of your husband. No one likes to have things pointed out, to be judged, to be criticized. So if you're doing this is one area you can reduce, change your approach, communicate better, and stop doing. Number two, being defensive during conflict. In order to have a productive conversation, both people need to be able to own their mistakes, own their responsibilities, and be there to listen to what is being shared. When you're defensive, it is really hard to work through the conversation because it's constantly being deflected. When you're making excuses, you're justifying what you're doing, and you're not actually hearing your partner out for what they're actually saying. Third one is shutting him out. Again, during an argument, you need to talk things through. It doesn't have to be in the moment, but things do eventually need to be talked about in order to resolve them and move forward in a way that actually helps your marriage make progress. When you shut your partner out, nothing can be resolved. Everything gets swept under the rug. You pretend like things are fine, and guess what happens? You encounter the same situation again, and it becomes a pattern. Your partner doesn't feel safe to share with you what they're upset about because it's not worth it anyway, because you're not willing to have a conversation about it, and they don't get their needs met. Number four, blame. If you are approaching your conversations in a way that is blaming your partner for things, blaming them for your unhappiness, blaming for what you aren't getting from them, then it can come off like an attack. And a lot of people don't respond well to that. They will either get defensive or they will just stop doing things altogether because what they are doing isn't working, it's not worth it, and they want to avoid feeling attacked. Number five, raising your voice at him. Now, I understand that when you're angry, it's really easy to allow that to affect how we communicate. Our calmness turns into frustration and angst and anger. But when you raise your voice, you are signaling to your spouse that things are getting really, really heated. You're losing control over yourself, and they either need to end the conversation and step away, or it's time for them to get defensive because you are in attack mode. Number six, speaking over him. Everybody deserves to feel heard and to get their time in to share whatever it is that they feel and they want. When you speak over them, you're essentially saying that what you want, what you say, what you prefer matters more than his thoughts, feelings, and needs. Speaking over him is going to only create feelings of disrespect and feeling like there's a power imbalance because you're basically talking over him and you don't respect what he has to say. You don't care. You don't want to listen, even if that isn't how you actually feel. Number seven, dismissing what he says. Even if you disagree, even if you think you know what they're going to say next, it's important to be aware of the times that you're dismissing what they say. If you continue dismissing what he says, then he is going to feel less inclined to share and feel like he is not really valued as a partner. And again, this is another way that is disrespecting him, what he brings to the table. And number 8 is rejecting his bids for connection. Whether he wants to go on a date with you, plan a solo vacation with you without the kids, he's trying to flirt with you, he's trying to initiate physical contact with you, whatever it is, feeling rejected doesn't feel good to anyone. No one likes to feel like they're not wanted or desired. And so if you're feeling tired, if you're feeling like you're not in the mood, find different ways to go about that so that it doesn't seem like everything that he's trying is just coming to a dead end and it's pointless, because sooner or later, he's just going to stop altogether. And I'm sure you don't want that either, because that's when you actually start creating co-parenting roommate sort of relationship rather than a romantic relationship. And your marriage needs to maintain a romantic relationship for it to be actually a marriage rather than a co-parenting situation. And the last one is not keeping your word. If you say you're going to do something, do it, right? It's hard to maintain and nurture trust when you say you're going to do something, but you go back on your word. So then it becomes a question in their minds of, are they actually going to do this? Can I actually trust them to do this? Or are they just saying that to get me off their back? So I just shared 9 ways that you may be negatively contributing towards lowering your magic ratio. Check in and be really honest with yourself about whether you are doing any of these and see what you can do to stop doing this, but still get your needs met. If you love this and want to continue learning more about how to make your marriage better so that you can love and enjoy and have a good example for your kids to look up to, follow me, Michelle Parda, Life Marriage Coach for Moms, and hit subscribe. See you later.